Here we go, it's last week of the auction, America's favorite top 10 list of auction results from around the globe, as hand-selected by me, Josh Levine, your host and guide to the world of auctions. This is episode 8 of season 2, and it's the hottest YouTube series and social media sensation in the world! Okay, the auction world. It's like you took a 49-year-old unemployed auctioneer, nailed a green sheet to the wall, gave him a cell phone, some internet access, and called it good. And it sounds like the stuff of legend and Emmy Award-winning television. Am I right? And yes, it's all true, and I got a great show for you. So welcome back, subscribers, and hello, newbies. We got the goods, amazing auction results, and so much more. What do I always tell you? Nothing is more interesting than the auction world, not even hateful tweets, posts, or nasty politics. So stay right here, and remember, before you leave, subscribe below, give this video a thumbs up, leave a comment or two, because sharing is caring and so very daring. And please, before you leave, have a look below at all the links I put down there. I have all my social media contacts down there, and most importantly, where you can find out more about these great auction houses. They have such cool stuff week in and week out. Okay, I hear you. Get on with it, Josh. Last week at the auction. Coming in at number 10 is the Sansui G-8000 Stereo Receiver that hammered for $1,400 at Leland Little in beautiful North Carolina. And if you're a fan of the show, you might be getting sick of all my audiophile education, but when you make your first score at your next yard sale or estate sale, you're gonna love me again. Learn your vintage electronics. It's a sleeper subculture with lots of demand and not a lot of people in the know. And this week, I got an idea. I'm gonna plan an earworm for you, because I always remember jingles and rhymes, so maybe this one will help you. When talking to boomers, ask if they have tube amps and tuners. I want you to make some money, people, all right? It's the only reason I do this. Okay, here's another one for my money-making lessons at number 9. It's a suite of Margot de Taxco AMPM silver jewelry that just brought $1,700 at John Moran in California, weighing in at 137.5 grams, which is just under 5 ounces. So if you're doing the scrap calc in your head, that's about 70 bucks. What did $70 bring at auction? $1,700, and this is no fluke. It's a name. Learn your Mexican silver makers. I told you about William Spratling a few weeks back, and here's another one to look for, but there are several. Here's my tip. If it's signed or marked Taxco or Mexican silver, and it's being sold at or near its weight in silver, just buy it. Buy it. You know, I can't tell you how many times, and very smart antique dealers just turn their noses up at silver and sell it for scrap. I'd rather be in these kind of profit margins, wouldn't you? You know, I'm gonna give you a bonus one here. Here, we'll call it number 9B. It's coral. This 18 karat gold bracelet just sold for $1,800 at Clars in Oakland. And red coral's another one. I've seen wraps recently and chokers with base metal clasps, not even gold or silver, from the 50s and 60s, bringing $200 and $300 on the regular. And you know, you're gonna find these at your yard sales for 20 and 30 bucks, and even in auctions and box lots, because they don't know. As often, you know, I always say it, you don't know everything. You can't know everything. I sure don't, but we can all learn something new every day. All right, number 8's fun. It's an 18th century Gustavian period Swedish trestle table that just hammered for $2,750 at A. Kleins in Castle Hayne, North Carolina. This is a beautiful example from approximately 1750, and I keep saying, I hope this is the trend. People are really starting to appreciate the real deal again. It's a cycle, and I think the cycle's headed in the right direction. Right in time for a market crash, too, so there's gonna be a lot of great stuff out there and great buys. Keep your eyes peeled and your dollars freed up. Okay. Let's get funky now. Number 7 is the Wendell Castle Grasshopper Mirror that brought $4,500 at Alderfer and Hatfield. Circa 2000, these are more thought of as art sculpture for obvious reasons, but it's a decorator's dream piece and a name you need to know in designers. Wendell Castle was not just the American furniture artist that made this piece, but often he was called the father of art furniture and the movement. For 4 decades, he created some of the most unique handmade sculptures and art furniture around the world. If you're not familiar with his work, be sure to learn more. It's truly a fascinating story. All right, number 6, carved lapis plaque of Christ that brought $7,500 at Artemis in Colorado. And I gotta put this piece into perspective for you. It was 1.5 inches by 2 inches, so you understand the scale. However, being from the 12th century Byzantine period, this lapis plaque and early depiction of Christ, these bidders really knew the value of this 800-year-old treasure, that it survived. You know, quite a rare find, and I just love that kind of stuff. All right. What's number 5? It's another beer can. I featured one last week and I gotta talk about this. White Horse Beer 32 ounce quart cone just brought $11,500 at Maureen's in Brimfield. I know about this secret subculture and the values of these old cone tops and sealed cans, but I'm still amazed every time I see them perform like this. And I just keep telling you, so you keep your eyes peeled. I want you to find a beer can collection so you can retire early. All right, let's move on to number four. It's a Picasso Bull Fighter Bowl, and it brought $21,500 at Copake Auctions in New York. It was signed and dated April 15th, 1953, and the bowl was approximately 7 1/4 inches in diameter. That's pretty small, but I want you to know this for a couple of reasons. Let's get on with it. Picasso ceramics are out there, and many families have these and don't even realize it. You know, there were a lot produced by Picasso in limited edition runs, and I once pointed out a small picture to a family above their mother's refrigerator, and I'm like, I think that's a Picasso, and they laugh. Well, when they sold it for $12,000, they didn't laugh. Always take a second look and have an appraiser come out when you're helping out with an estate. All right, next one's awesome. Number three, Chinese blue and white. Always have Chinese. $37,500 at Clars in Oakland. This piece, it was 2.8 inches in diameter and had an $800 to $1,200 estimate. Chinese antiques are lottery tickets. Just buy them when you run across anything cool and old at an estate sale, because if you've watched this season so far, you know what I'm talking about. Number two, let's get nuts. This is a Michael Jordan rookie card. Just brought $65,000 at Catone's in Geneseo, New York. It was mint 10, and I want to explain this. It's a 34-year-old card that was mass-produced, and it brought that kind of money. But let me cover something here and explain why, because this is all about the grade. All right, so you find an unopened pack of 1986 Fleer basketball cards. You get super excited, and you open it up, and oh my gosh, there's a Michael Jordan rookie card in there. Must be mint, right? You're the first person to ever touch it. Let's keep going. Was that card under the piece of gum? Did it get all scratched up? Was the sugar dust there and get all over it? No? Okay. So it's perfect, right? No. Did the die cut machine have a good day that day? That's the machine that actually cut them out of the sheets. And this is usually where it goes awry. The machine was typically off a little bit. Just a little bit makes the photos off center, and therefore it's not a perfect 10. So you basically need all the stars to align for this. But you know, isn't it fun hunting? So what's number one this week? Let's get into it. It's George Woodall, Thomas Webb and Sons Cameo Glass Vase that sold for $95,000 at Heritage. I have not seen Cameo Glass bring this kind of money as of late, but this circa 1887 example was super rare and super fine. 9.5 inches tall, so that's 10,000 bucks an inch. Cameo Glass is truly thought of as a luxury art glass, and it's been around actually since Roman times. It was produced by cameo etching and carving through fused colored layers of glass to produce these intricate and beautiful designs. The late 19th century saw the return of this lost art form, and it really perfected it. These makers like Tiffany, Gallet, Daum, and Thomas Webb produced some of the finest known examples. Today, you need to watch for reproductions, but they're knowing there's serious value in these early 20th century finds, you know, makes you keep hunting. So happy hunting. Again, now you know what happened last week at the auction. So this, hey, it's time for viewer's email. We're just going to get into it. I got James C. from Denver, and he asked, is now a good time to sell my toy collection? That's a great question. But I need a little more information for you specifically, but I'm going to be broad here. You know, what era of toys are we talking about? So let me just give you my take. If it's the late 1970s or early 80s, they're super hot right now. What do I always say? Strike when the iron's hot. Sell now. If it's 50s, 60s toys, you know, they've been super soft with the exception of the super rare things, but the market is stabilized. So, you know, I don't see it fluctuating much in the next 5 to 10 years. So you have to decide whether you want to hang on to it, store it, and whether that's worth it or not. 1990s toys are just heating up. So I'd watch a little bit, but don't wait too long. When you see the prices get crazy, time to sell. If you really want my in-depth thoughts, check out my book, Why Don't You Want My Stuff? Just came out on Audible. Great audio edition. It came out awesome. I'm really thrilled with it. Great question, James. I hope that helps. Thanks, everyone, again. And don't forget to email me at josh@joshlevinespeaks, where you, too, can send me any and all questions. And before I go, if you enjoyed the show, subscribe below. Give the video a thumbs up, leave a comment, and be sure to check out all the great auction houses I talked about. Support your local auctioneers. They are some of the hardest working people in business. Show business. All right, until next week or last week at the auctions.